Hello there, Thomas.
Hello, sir. Taking a ride today?
Yes, indeed. I need a lift to Dryor.
Two stops down. Right away, sir.
Hello. How's she coming along?
I've got good news and bad news.
Fergus, the traction engine, had been on limited service after an accident. While other engines worked in his place, Fergus dozed in the sun. He awoke as his driver approached.
Derek has broken down again. We've got to make a run to Croven's Gate to retrieve the mechanic.
Not a problem.
Fergus's driver went off to phone the mechanic. Fergus spotted Sir Topham Hatt. He looked busy. He perked up when he saw Fergus.
Ah, Fergus. How are you getting on?
I'm all right, sir. I've mostly been a spare engine since my flywheel's been sticking and all.
Well, a spare engine is just what I need. I've got a special job for you.
Sure, sir. What is it?
Can you keep a secret?
Sure.
For Sodor Day, we're unveiling something special at Great Waterton. I'd like you to collect it from Dryar tomorrow and bring it there.
I'll try, sir. I can't carry very much with my flywheel and all.
Not to worry. It's not that heavy.
Arr, what be the matter, Fergus? Ye look awfully glum.
I'm just nervous. I've got an important job tonight and I don't even know what it is.
Ah, ye be afraid ye may not do it right?
Since my flywheel's been damaged, I can't pull heavy loads like I used to.
Ah, not to worry, Fergus. Look to the tugboats out at sea.
What?
For its size. The tugboat be the most powerful craft afloat.
But I can hardly tug anything. I don't understand.
Arr, but ye be as small as a tugboat. Though they may be small, they do their job better in ships 100 times their size. Maybe ye can't haul, but ye be the hardest worker I ever did meet. Ye do what ye can, better than all the rest.
I see. Thank you, Salty.
Not to worry, me hearty.
That night, Fergus arrived at Dryor. His driver had no sooner hopped onto the station platform when a man stepped out of the shadows. Fergus was surprised.
Are you here to take her away?
Take who away?
She's cleaned up as new as can be. But try as I might, I can't make her steam. There's just too much damage, and not enough time.
Who are you talking about? Driver, what is going on?
This is our special job, Fergus.
Fergus, my name is Burnett, and I'd like you to meet Lady.
Thank you.
I've been working to restore Lady for the better part of 3 years.
Where did she come from?
She was built right here in this shed a lifetime ago. A brilliant engineer built her to show people what steam engines could do. She's the pride of Sodor and beyond.
How come I've never heard of her before?
After her owner passed away, his son took ownership. The son didn't care for railways, though. He didn't know how to treat her. He wouldn't let anyone see her. And when he did take her out, he was reckless. I've been trying to buy her for years, but he wouldn't sell.
So, what happened?
We finally agreed on a price a few years back. But before I could take her someplace safe, he damaged her. Intentionally. She lost pieces. Wheels, cylinders, even her nameplates were missing. And I've been putting the pieces back together ever since.
Sir Topham Hatt wants to present Lady at Great Waterton and Sodor Day. We're going to take her there tonight.
I see. I feel honored, sir.
Be good to her, Fergus. There are too many men in this world working against what we fight to save.
Burnett told me you had a problem with shunting.
I do. I can't pull much weight. I was on a rock slide, you see, and...
You've done just fine tonight.
Well, tonight's not my usual kind of job. I'm usually at the cement works.
You look like you belong in a museum.
You're one to talk.
True. We're both old souls.
They don't build engines like us anymore.
They don't save engines like us anymore, either.
What do you mean?
Haven't you heard what's happened on the mainland?
No.
They're all gone. Engines like us.
That can't be true. Their controllers would never let that happen.
But they did. The age of steam has ended, Fergus.
Not on Sodor.
Sodor's next. It's coming for us all.
Who? Who's coming for us?
I dare not say its name. An abomination. A diesel. Insidious and bloodthirsty. Whose only purpose is destruction. It's been reaping England and beyond. Twisting metal and vanquishing history. For 10,000 years.
But why doesn't someone stop it?
No one can. It's a symptom, Fergus.
Is it why I'm protecting you tonight?
Who said you were protecting me?
Well, it certainly seems like I am. What they said about Sam Bauman damaging you, it seems like they're trying hard to keep you out of sight.
Bauman's not around anymore. The only thing an engine like myself is hiding from at this point is time. Have you ever heard of the Mockingbird, Fergus?
No.
Mockingbirds repeat calls they hear from other birds. And then other mockingbirds repeat those calls. It can go on forever. Do you know what that means?
No, what?
It means there are mockingbirds alive today, singing the songs of extinct birds. Their voices are being carried on past their own lifetime.
So, what are you saying?
I'm saying that the changes approaching are inevitable, Fergus. we won't be here forever. But our voices can be carried on after we're gone. I was created to serve as tribute to all the steam engines that came before me. Even my voice will be lost one day.
The next day, Fergus was being loaded with supplies for Great Waterton at Croven's Gate. Rusty arrived on the line nearby.
Have you ever been to the mainland?
No, never.
I've heard horrible stories there, from the places where only the diesels work.
I only work maintenance on my line here on Sodor. I don't associate with the diesels on the mainland.
I heard about one diesel that's set out to destroy all steam engines. They say it's a menace.
Oh, you must be talking about Diesel 10. Yeah, I've heard about him.
Diesel 10?
Yeah, but I'm not entirely sure if he's really, you know, real. They say he's a superstition. Apparently he's been spotted around here on Sodor for hundreds of years, which doesn't even make any sense. And they say he's a shapeshifter, too. Driver tells me it's a load of nonsense.
Shapeshifter.
I did have one strange experience. It was a few years ago. I was working in the old boulder quarry and, there were some strange things happening on that site that I just can't really explain.
What do you mean?
You know, objects moving as if they had a mind of their own. I don't like to entertain these kind of, you know, crazy ideas, but if there were a shapeshifter on Sodor, it would account for a lot of the things I've seen on that part of the island. I wouldn't let it rattle you too much. Just focus on being a really useful engine.
That night, Fergus delivered the supplies to Great Waterton. Lady was still in her shed.
The workmen have been polishing me up all day.
Has any engine been through here to see you?
I've heard whistles, but I've been at the back of the shed for the most part.
Well, that's good.
What have you done all day?
Odd jobs.
The usual, then.
Make this quick, Fergus. It's unwise of us to go poking around someplace like this.
I just wanted to see the place for myself.
Fergus, you're not getting swept up in all that superstition, are you?
No, not at all.
All right then, let's turn back.
It's real.
What's real?
The monster. You spoke with Rusty the other day. I overheard.
How do you know anything about the monster?
Well, I saw it myself once.
You did? But they say it destroys steam engines. How did you survive?
No!
I was brave.
She's looking great. Old Mr. Bauman would be proud.
I saw Mr. Bauman once when I was a boy. He was a good man. Dedicated.
He understood things few people understand anymore.
Well, we've still got you. And me, of course. So you've had me thinking maybe we should try and save some more engines out of the smelter's yard near Kildane. Oh, I've spoken with the man in charge there before.
What did he look like?
Oh, thin fellow. Tall. Black hat. Well, now I've just gone and described myself. What I mean to say is he had a...
hat with a broad brim, black clothing.
Indeed. You know him?
No.
Your light engine again tonight.
It wasn't on purpose. The supply was delayed, but my spot at the sheds was already taken, so I just...
I'm just teasing, Fergus. You're fine. I'd be lonely without my little friend here at night.
Little?
There's nothing wrong with being little.
You need to see the miniature engines at Arnsdale. Now those engines are little.
I haven't seen Arnsdale in years. It was home to a different railway the last time I was there.
Did you used to explore all over the island?
And beyond. The world was so fresh and green back then. Not like now. But even then, it was more gilded than it appeared.
Are you always this depressing?
I've told you, Fergus, I'm an old soul. Time weighs heavily on my heart.
Engines don't have hearts.
Some of them don't. We went to London once.
How was it?
Lovely. Cold and rainy, but lovely anyway.
That's the farthest you've been from Sodor?
For now.
So you have plans to travel?
I go where my owners take me.
I've heard stories about your old owner.
Which one?
The bad one.
There's not much to say. He kept me in a storage shed for 10 years. And when the time came to sell me, he walked into the shed with a duffel bag full of tools. I was never the same engine after that.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Old Mr. Bauman was a kind man. He was proud of me. I always knew that. He used to take me on rides every day, back in the glory days. The time we spent together. That golden, magical feeling. He called it shining.
Another shining day, lady.
It's something I'll never forget.
I like my driver, too.
Mr. Bauman built me with his own two hands to show the world that steam engines were still viable.
That's what the Fat Controller's Railway is all about.
I've hardly seen it in years. Aren't there diesels about?
There are, but most of them are kind.
Most of them? It only takes one villain.
I've still never seen this villain you speak of. I've been asking around...
Don't dare speak of it. It preys on your fear.
I'm sorry, I won't. Please, tell me more about old Mr. Bauman.
Mr. Bauman worked on the mainland in his youth.
Oh no.
People can be an engine's best friend.
I like all the workers at the cement works.
All the men that work on Sodor have been very kind. Oh. I think we'd best get to sleep, Fergus.
All right. Good night.
Good night, Fergus.
Hey, lady. I'm glad we're friends.
I'm glad we're friends too, Fergus. Now, good night.
It wasn't long before Fergus and Lady were both fast asleep. It also wasn't long before Fergus gently stirred from his slumber. He opened a tired eye and peered into the empty shed opposing him.
Lady?
But there was no engine there.
What is it, Fergus?
I was having the nicest dream.
Lady's gone.
What do you mean?
She's not here.
How can she be gone? Fergus, you're blocking the only line of track she couldn't possibly have gotten out of the shed.
There are some strange things happening that I just can't really explain.
That's what I'm afraid of.
She's gone.
I'm so sorry, Mr. Stone. I have no idea what happened. I
do. It's not your fault, Engine. That thing is a monster.
But you said it was all superstition.
Remember the night we visited the smelter's yard? That engine. It spoke of a horned beast that was the eater of worlds. He said it was death and time.
The smelters. I suppose we all have to go home one day. Sir, may I borrow this engine?
If it's all right with Fergus, I'm keen to go back to bed.
What's the plan, Mr. Stone?
We find her.
What if the monster finds us first?
I've dealt with him before.
I can't see anything. There's no sign of her.
If they're anywhere, they're here.
Well, well, Fergus. We thought you didn't like it here.
Get us out of here! I didn't see Lady anywhere.
I'm sorry, Fergus. The truth is, that monster could have gone anywhere. I just thought he would be here.
Wait a minute. I have an idea. Hello? Is anyone there?
Lady?
Lady? Lady?
I'll return you for the night, Fergus. No sense wasting more coal on this wild goose chase.
Hold on, Mr. Stone. Diesel 10, I'm looking for you. Where is she? Show yourself!
Oh dear.
No worries. I've got a flywheel. We can power my lamp right back up in moments.
Fergus turned his flywheel until his lamp was recharged. Slowly, the lamp flickered back to life.
Diesel 10! Lady!
Get away from her, demon.
You should have waited. I was going there next.
What do we do? We can't go back there by ourselves. Maybe we should tell the Fat Controller. He could do something about this.
Sir Topham Hatt has no idea this is going on. He can't stop it. Nobody can.
Then what are we doing out here?
We're doing the best we can.
I don't like that answer. Mr. Stone, please tell me you know something you're not telling me about how we can save Lady.
I've been chasing this monster for years. I don't know how to kill it, but it's been stopped before. Temporarily.
Are we completely sure this is where it went?
Run! There's something in there!
I think this is the right place.
Where is she? Answer!
Very brave, little one. But I am beyond fear.
Give her back!
Demon! It's me. I am here.
She will burn nicely in my fire.
Show yourself. Why her?
Before there was life, there was nothing. I was there.
Before there was steam, there was peace. I was there too. After there is steam, time carries on.
You just want to undo my work.
My work is your undoing. Your new acquisition will fail you just as she did.
I'm a hard worker. I'm the pride of the cement works.
Fergus, you better stay out.
Put him down.
You are funny, little one.
I may be little, but all of you know that little engines can do big things. I don't...
Fergus, do something!
I... Mr. Stone, are you all right?
What's fine, lady?
And after we do, let's make sure Sir Topham finds out about this.
Is change.
Wait, don't!
We're on the scene of a nasty fire at the Sodor Smelter's Yard. The cause of which is yet unknown.
There you are, Fergus. I didn't know where you would turn up.
We couldn't save her.
You didn't find Lady?
I don't know.
Where's Mr. Stone?
I don't know.
Sodor Day came and went. The FAV controller chose to keep Lady's restoration and subsequent disappearance a secret.
I don't know why we carry on with these silly traditions anyway.
Fergus resumed his job at the Sodor Cement Works. He was able to pull more trucks than he had been, but his flywheel never fully recovered from his accident. Fergus was at Croven's Gate, picking up equipment. He thought of Lady. He remembered what Lady had said about mockingbirds.
There are mockingbirds alive today, singing the songs of extinct birds. Their voices are being carried on past their own lifetime.
Fergus still wasn't sure what Lady was talking about, until he heard a familiar whistle.
Lady? It can't be.
But it wasn't Lady. It was a new engine Fergus had never seen before.
Bonjour, Talemo.
Where am I?
That's him?
Hello, sir. Welcome.
Burnett!